Hi everyone, Ben here from musictheoryacademy.com. In this lesson, we're going to be having a look at cadences. And we're going to look at the following. Firstly, what is a cadence? Secondly, we're going to look at finished and unfinished cadences. I'm also going to introduce you to the four main types of cadence that you'll come across. And finally, we're going to have a look at how to use cadences in our compositions. So firstly, what is a cadence? Well, a cadence is simply a chord progression of at least two chords that ends a phrase or a section of music. Music is like spoken word. It's divided into phrases. It's divided into sections. Let's have a look at an example in spoken word. Here's a well-known children's rhyme. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again. This is divided into phrases. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall, Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. That phrase sounds finished. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again. That phrase also sounds finished. But there's a phrase in the middle, all the king's horses and all the king's men, that is unfinished. Okay, it sounds like it's got to keep going. All the king's horses and all the king's men, it doesn't make sense until you put something after it. Couldn't put Humpty together again. Music is exactly the same. You have phrases in music that sound finished, and you have phrases in music that sound unfinished. And it is the choice of cadence at the end of a phrase that determines whether it sounds finished or unfinished. So let's have a look at the finished cadences in music. Okay, finished cadences, not surprisingly, always end on chord one. That's what gives it the sense that the phrase is finished. And there are two types of finished cadences. The first is the perfect cadence, which is sometimes known as the authentic cadence as well. And this goes from chord 5 to chord 1. So let's have a look at an example in C major. Here I've got a short musical phrase. It's only 2 bars long. But you can see that it ends with the chord 5 followed by chord 1. That is the cadence, and in notation you get this little line between the two chords that indicates the cadence. Let's have a listen to this example. You can hear clearly how the cadence and the movement from 5 to 1 gives this definite sense that it is finished. Let's have a listen to the example again, but this time in C minor. Again, you can hear how this perfect cadence at the end, the chords 5 to 1, gives this definite, complete, finished sound to it. So that's the first finished cadence. The second finished cadence is called the Plagal cadence. Now, this goes from chord 4 to chord 1. This again sounds finished, but it's a gentler finish than the perfect cadence. It's sometimes called the Amen cadence because it's often used in very traditional hymns to sing Amen at the end of the hymn. Let's have a look and a listen to an example of a Plagal cadence, again in C major. You can hear how it sounds finished, but it's a gentler finish than the perfect cadence. Let's have a listen to it, this time in C minor. So those are our two finished cadences. We have the perfect or authentic cadence, which is chord 5 to 1, and the Plagal cadence, which is chords 4 to 1. So what about the unfinished cadences? Well, not surprisingly, these never end on chord 1, because if they did end on chord 1, they would sound finished. Again, we've got two types of unfinished cadence. You've got the imperfect cadence, which is sometimes known as the half cadence. Now, this ends on chord 5, but it can be chord 1 to 5, chord 2 to 5, or chord 4 to 5. You've got three different options of how to approach the cadence. Here's an example in C major. I've used chord 1 before chord 5. Listen to how this sounds unfinished. You can clearly hear that the phrase wants to continue, the music wants to move on to something else. Let's have a listen to the example, this time in C minor. again you can hear how the phrase sounds unfinished. The second type of unfinished cadence is the interrupted or deceptive cadence. Now this is a wonderful cadence, the clue's in the name. It's a surprise. Something happens that you're not expecting. And this goes from chord 5 usually to chord 6. Now the listener is often expecting it to go from chord 5 to chord 1. They're expecting this perfect cadence, but instead they get this surprising sound. Have a listen to the interrupted cadence in C major. You can hear how the music sounds as though it's going to go back to chord 1, but it doesn't. In comes this chord 6 instead. Have a listen to it in the minor key. I love the interrupted cadence in a minor key because chord 6 is actually a major chord, and so you get this wonderfully distinctive, interrupted and deceptive sound. So those are the two unfinished cadences. So how do we use cadences? Well, we use cadences to end a phrase in our music compositions, and we need to ask this question: do I want the phrase that I'm writing to sound finished or not? Okay, do I want the music to sound finished? If the answer to that is yes, then we choose a finished cadence, and you've got two options: the authentic and perfect or the plagal. Now usually you will use the authentic and perfect, you'll use 5-1. But sometimes you may want that more gentle sound of the plagal. If the answer is no, that you don't want your phrase to sound finished, then you choose either the imperfect or the interrupted. Again, typically you'll use the imperfect, okay, so 1, 2, 4-5, but sometimes you just might want to bring this element of surprise into your composition by using the interrupted cadence and going from chords 5-6. So what have we learnt? Well, we've learnt what is a cadence. Okay, cadence is a series of at least two chords that ends a musical phrase. They've got finished and unfinished cadences depending on whether the music sounds like it's going to finish there or keep going. There are four types of cadence that we've looked at: the perfect and authentic, the plagal, the imperfect / half, and the interrupted / deceptive. And then we've looked a little bit at how to use cadences in your composition. If you head over to my site, I've got an article on cadences. There's lots more information there. I've also put together a list of all the different cadences in all the keys, major and minor. So you can use that. You can download it, print it off. Use it as a reference point when you're composing. I really hope that's helped you get an understanding of cadences, and I hope that you're able to use them effectively in your compositions.